Good evening, and thanks for joining us for the 64th Annual Festival of Christmas. It is my great pleasure to welcome you to this beloved Bethel tradition. While our festival celebration looks different this year, I am so grateful for their resiliency, passion, and commitment our students have shown as they prepared to share their incredible talents with us in this virtual format. I had the chance to sneak in and listen to them practice, and I know you'll be blessed as I was. Fittingly, this year's theme is For God So Loved the World. As we face the challenges of a global pandemic, racial tension, and national disunity, it is more important than ever for us to hear the good news of Christ's coming. God so loved the world that he sent Jesus to bring peace on earth and light in the darkness. By giving us the gift of his Son, God granted us the opportunity for reconciliation with himself and with one another. No matter how challenging the state of the world, God's love is eternal. And it is in that truth that we find comfort, peace, and hope. As you receive the gift of music from our students and directors, we pray that you will experience the joy of the Lord and share it with others this Christmas season. Again, thank you for being part of this special event and enjoy the performance.
Gloria, in excelsis Deo, gloria, 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 gloria being a senior with this year, it's been a bit of a mixed bag.
A very weird and cluttered time.
There's so much disjunct and so much not normal.
And yet, this story is bigger than all of that. It's still more important than the election, than the pandemic, the fact that the Word became flesh and lived among us. And that message is so powerful that we have to tell it every year.
December and November are so looked forward to because of festival.
This year it's really important to unite people around the holiday and just the joy that comes from the Christmas season.
And right now, I think almost even more so than any time, to give the students something that they can say, we shared in this together, to bring their families and the community something that is beautiful, that glorifies God, that says, despite what's going on around us, we can still bring beauty and represent praise in this world. That's why doing it, even to an empty room.
It really is the hallmark of the music department to me, and a hallmark of Bethel, like, community to me. And so if we didn't have anything for it, then truly it would feel like just this semester in the year is somewhat lost.
Faculty and staff start planning for it in early summer. Like, it's no joke.
We had meeting after meeting trying to decide, do we do Festival of Christmas? And if we do, how do we do Festival of Christmas?
It took us a little longer to get started this year just because of COVID and the protocols and how do you do music in the COVID environment.
And what we came up with was the fact that it was important for the seniors, for the community, for the singers, for the school to keep the tradition going and not be deterred by what was happening outside of our control.
I've really appreciated that they have continued with festival this year, even considering the circumstances.
It's the start of the Christmas season proper. It's the ending of the semester, but it's also a chance for all of Bethel and all of my family, you know, and the Bethel family to worship together.
Like, it's really the icing on the cake. Like, it tops everything that I have ever been a part of.
In terms of how much work goes into festival, it's an insane amount.
I don't want to know how much Kevin puts into it because we would feel really guilty, I think.
It involves more than 200 students. It involves the entire school kind of making headway to this celebration of Christ's birth.
And it's very rewarding for the performers to put so much effort into the concert and then be a part of such an amazing production.
Because it's a fun experience and it's nice to be around your peers and to work hard and have a product that at the end you can say, like, that was worth everything. Like, all the tears, all the sweat, all the blood, the late nights, all of that, it was all worth it.
You really see it in the final product, right? You see the just enormous amount of hours that Kevin and Dr. Vinker and Dr. Thompson and the other faculty that have just put into it. And I think that's what makes it so incredible when you see it. That's what makes it possible.
What a wonderful thing for us to bring, us as a community, as a school, to bring forth this effort and this heart and this passion for God through song.
And that we can still bring joy and love in such hard and tumultuous times such as now. It's very important to remember just how much our voices actually matter. And that the hard work isn't in vain.
Thank you. Thank you.